Hi YouTubers, welcome back to my channel and thanks so much. Today's discussion is about paying off your mortgage ahead of time. So we're going to be answering some questions about would you pay off your mortgage ahead of time, what that looks like, why we did it, what we considered, and what the benefit was, and how much did we save in interest by doing that. So let's take a look at the reasons why we did it and some of the benefits that you'll see and find as well. So there are first some questions that we had to ask ourselves. One of the questions is, what is the financial benefit? The second was, what is our benefit in retirement? The third was, what is the emotional benefit? Is there a heart benefit? The fourth is, does this accelerate our retirement savings? That's a big one. The fifth was, what is the flexibility of not having a mortgage? And then the sixth is, for legacy planning for our future, is there a benefit to having no debt on certain properties like your personal residence? So we're gonna be talking about all of those, and I'll have a snapshot of the money that we saved as well. And I really love saving money, and I really love the idea of thinking about my future retirement, because my husband retired early and we're constantly trying to figure out, okay, how much money do we need per month? How much money do we need to exist? How much money are we gonna have to pay extra for, let's say, medical? Because next year he'll be eligible for, or this year, I think, yes, this year he's eligible for Medicare as soon as he turns 65 in September, which is just crazy to think. So what is that plus supplemental, apparently? So those are those things that are really, really important, and you can noodle those for a long time. So we have created a monthly spreadsheet, and we constantly look at our net worth, our debt, and our monthly expenses. And that was why we decided to go ahead and pay off our mortgage, because you know, our mortgage was low. You know, a lot of times people will say, why would I pay off my mortgage when my interest is 3% or 2.75 or 3.25? Interest now is 6% or 6.5 without points or with points, you know? So why would I pay off my mortgage? And I'll tell you, there are reasons why. So as we look forward to retirement, we are looking at what is our monthly that we need per month, and how can we save more money so that we end up not having to work as many years. And paying off our mortgage in advance actually gave us $171,000-ish back in our pocket in interest savings for the life of that loan. So
were to give you some money out of my wallet, would that ease the pain?
We had only had the loan since 2021, and that's only 3 years. So the loan was all the interest is front loaded on mortgages. And that's just so that the bank gets paid, because they're giving you the loan and it makes total financial sense for the banks. So they front load that. So if your interest is front loaded, that means the first 12 years of that loan, most of that money goes to pay those interest payments. So for us, because we were so close to that first, you know, initial payment, we saved, it was a very low loan. It was like $300,000, but we still saved $171,000. And if we, let's say we need $5,000 a month, that's $60,000 a year. So you take 60 into that 170, and now we have 3 additional years almost that we don't have to work, right? Because we save that much money. So if you look at it like that, like, okay, by paying off this loan, I saved 3 years in retirement. That's phenomenal, right? Now, let's say I decide to continue working until I'm 70 something or whatever, then it doesn't really matter However, that just means that I'll have that much more money in my pocket by the time I do decide to actually retire and not work anymore. Now, and don't get me wrong, I'm in real estate, so I help people get debt all the time, not because I'm a lender, but because I'm in real estate and people usually buy a home with mortgage debt. So it's not that I'm against it at all, because I'm not. In fact, I kind of dragged my feet on paying off our mortgage. And my husband did the math for me and was able to say, Elizabeth, we are saving $171,000 in interest payments. Don't you want to put that money into your pocket? And of course, that of course, ding, 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 that's my love language, is saving money any way you can. And that's one of them. So paying off the mortgage early was that benefit for us. And then once we did it, we had all these other ding, 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 ding benefits. One, we had the emotional benefit of being able to say we own our home and we're pretty secure, other than paying for our property insurance as well as our taxes, which are pretty low. You know, there aren't that many things that we have to come up with every month. We save a lot of additional money by doing some things that I'll show you in another video. You know, how those household things that you can do to save money really do work. And so we had that emotional benefit. So emotional benefit is one of those really big reasons why to pay off that. So there's this head, which is, it makes financial sense. Then there's the heart, which it makes emotional sense. And we have goals. And so it check marks one of our goals. Our goals being to be financially free of debt by the time I retire, which is gonna be about 10 years from now. And so that checks off one of those financial goals. So super excited about that. The other thing that we also needed to do was to make sure that it helped our legacy. So if our legacy is to leave some property to our children, what we don't want to do is burden them with a bunch of debt. We want them to be able to either acquire the properties that we have and divvy them up appropriately, or sell them and be able to then take that money and have, you know, a more accelerated life. For me, when my father passed away, my mother had already passed away, but you know, 150, I think the value of my portion in death was about $150,000. And that allowed us to buy a home that we had sold our home, and we had some land, but getting that extra infusion of money allowed us to buy a home. And that was a game changer for us when we moved to Idaho. So, you know, a small infusion of cash into your kid's life can make a huge difference in their financial freedom and financial future as well. So we talk about, some people talk about not giving your kids money, but I think giving something like, you know, $200,000 or $300,000 does not spoil your kids. You know, giving them $1 million each, it may be a problem, right? But you know, there's some statistics that say that it, you know, they'll lose it, but several $100,000s is not gonna spoil your children. So, but it can make a big difference in their life. Like, they could buy a rental and have cash flow with that money, and that could change their life and their legacy. So I think that there are some really cool benefits of giving your kids a legacy and making sure that it's not so much and so big that they end up quitting everything and not working and then burning through all that money and not being able to leave their children something. And I just don't believe in that either. I do believe that being generous with your kids is important and being able to create a really big life. So one of the flexibilities that happens when you have that extra cash is the ability to save. So if saving, also having a big savings account, checkmarks a box for you, then I would say for us, that was very important. Both my husband and I love having savings accounts. We have separate savings accounts and we have a joint savings account, and I like saving money and he likes saving money. We were both raised that way. My father was very fiscally conservative, and his father and mother were also and are still alive, and so they are very fiscally responsible. So saving money was really, really important. So we take that mortgage payment and we put that in savings, and that really kind of makes us feel really, really good. The financial security of that is really nice to have. I like paying cash for a car, so that allows me to save up for that. It allows me to save up for other things in the household whether it's new countertops or a new light fixture or new cabinets or something like that. I like to cash flow that, and a lot of those things are big ticket items. You know, it's $10,000 here and $10,000 there, and but if you have that in savings, then you can take that money and cash flow that. I also do believe that you need to stay up on your home and make improvements every single year so that you don't have a ton of deferred maintenance. So you always, painting the house or, making sure you have, good windows and your HVAC is good and, all those things that do mean a lot if you ever go to sell that home and then you're not burdened with $100,000 of repair or deferred maintenance when you go to sell. So those are very important things as well. So one of the additional benefits of paying off your mortgage is the feeling of security. And what I mean by that is that when you don't have that mortgage over your home, then you feel more secure. And it's very hard to explain. It is a very good feeling. I remember when my dad paid off his mortgage, we were also saying, "Hey Dad, you can afford your mortgage. You don't need to pay it off." He wanted to do it, and he said, "It makes me feel better." And when he did it, he was so proud of himself. And I remember that feeling. I remember him feeling that way. And I would say that we felt that way as well. And we kind of hooped and hollered, and we were very, very grateful. And I would say that, going to bed every night, being incredibly grateful that we own our home and that we have a home and a roof over our head is something that we never forget. There was a time in our life when we didn't have a home. We were living in a trailer. We were struggling. And I'll tell you, it's a blessing to own your own home and have that security of that roof over the head, having to make only enough money to pay your taxes and your overhead expenses. There's something to be said for all of that. It is such a blessing, and to come from that place of being so grateful every time my head hits the pillow, every night when I say my prayers, I say, "I'm so grateful that we have this home. I'm so grateful that we have this roof over our head, and I am so grateful that we own our home." And so if that makes your heart sing too, then I'd love to have a discussion with you to help you make those decisions and to talk through those things. As a real estate agent, again, we help people buy and sell homes all of the time. And I also help people spitball or noodle, what is the best next move for us? And this is not meant as financial advice. I am not a financial advisor. I'm not a licensed financial advisor. However, I am a woman in my 50s looking at retirement, and I can help you look at retirement too and kind of say, what are those things that you can do so that you can set yourself up to have a really happy life? And as always, be safe, be happy, and be home. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like this.